you wouldn't just talk about Bill Gates and his family may go on began. Then you get to Bill Gates, somebody would have to recognize and pause right there, even if it's a pregnant pause, and say that this man was a bad Negro. He built Babylon. As a matter of fact, he was so powerful. Nimrod, he united the world, as it were at that time, made them into one, like organized, built pyramids, and he built temples and statues to the point where, and the streets, to the point where God had to come down. And there's been a character assassination against Nimrod. The Bible didn't say that God cursed Nimrod or God he did anything wrong. He was just a builder. And yet people talk about, all we talk about is a Tower of Babel. They built Babel and Babel was against God. But nobody stops like the writer and talks about this Nimrod that built and that to the point where God had to say, if I don't come down and stop this Negro, he's going to spoil my plan. Because and I think sometimes we rely too much on biblical commentary. And we need to recognize that we need the Bible to speak to our identity. And I tell you, the reason why a lot of black men from the ages of 18 to 35 don't come to church is because the Bible speaks to their spiritual man, but not to their black identity. The Bible has to speak to our black identity. Why? Because our identity is being attacked all the time. So when I come to church, I don't want to just hear about my spiritual man. I don't want to just hear about how I'm filled with the Holy Spirit. But I want to hear about Nimrod. I want to hear about Cush. I want to hear about these strong black men like Simon of Cyrene who carried the cross. Because that's helped me in a society, in a city as a black man on no time. You know,